hashtag art. With the summer months almost among us here in the UK, I thought a nice under the ocean art project would be a fabulous way to get crafty. This is a stained glass paper project, so it's inspired by stained glass, but it's really easy and really fun to do. I'm also going to link down below an outline of the shark if you feel that that'll help you create this piece of art yourself. But of course, I encourage you to have a go at sketching out your own shark or scene or whatever it is you want to create. You will also need some black glue, which I'm going to link down below how to make, and some watercolors or paints of your choosing. So come on then, let's take a look and see how this wonderful shark is made. So to begin with, you'll need a pencil, an eraser, a ruler if you want to, some black glue, we'll talk about that again in a minute, and I've got some watercolour paper here, but ordinary paper will do. Now, we're going to do a shark today, and the way I do a shark is I get a piece of paper and I sketch out different versions of it first, so you kind of practice, so don't do it first time. It's okay to practice and have a go on some scrap paper first. So I'm going to be bold. I'm going to take my rough drawing and I'm going to try and replicate it over here. So for the shark, you kind of need a pointy nose, quite pointy. And then we're going to just get the basic shape come down. So it's kind of like an oval or like an eye. I'm going to have the fin at the back. A big fin here, that's obviously quite an important part of the shark. And then the two fins on the side. There we go. And you know what, if it's not perfect, don't worry about it. Just get your razor and then just rub it out a little bit. So you don't need to have it too exact. You know, this is... It doesn't have to be perfect. This is not about being perfect. This is just about experimenting and having fun. Then I'm going to put a little eye. I think a shark's got quite a small eye. And then I'm going to put a scary, sort of grumpy looking mouth with some teeth. So this is my basic shark. Okay. Now, because this is my underwater scene and I want to make it look like a stained glass, I want to have a surface at the bottom. I know you can't see it, my piece of paper is too big, let's move the camera a little bit. This is going to be the water at the bottom. I want some like algae to come out, and I'm doing it in bits because this is going to be like stained glass, isn't it? So the algae's got sections. I also want kind of some waves, just to kind of give the picture some texture. Not waves, but you know, sort of the underwater movement. And then maybe one more, because these are all going to be coloured in later. In fact, for that reason, I'm going to do an extra one. And then I'm going to pretend that there's kind of light coming from the top. And this is going to give my stained glass kind of... it's different patterns and shapes. So for the light to come, I'm going to pretend it's up here. So this is going to be my center, like as if it's the rubber, and I'm going to draw some straight lines coming from it down, all the way down, going through all my drawings. Maybe three or four of these, we'll have a look. And these will help define some of our stained glass. Feels a bit weird drawing lines through your drawing, doesn't it? But just persevere and then you'll see where this is going. I'm going to do it up here as well, all the way to the top. Maybe have another wave coming in that way, because it's not actually a sunshine, is it? It's just the shapes. I think we need a couple more coming over here. And then maybe a wave coming in like that. Okay, so I think that's a good start for our shark shape. I do want to kind of just break up the shark a bit so that, again, it has that sort of stained glass effect. I'm just going to add some extra shapes following some of the curves of the shark already. So I have a natural curve coming down this way, and then I might just stick another one over here. So we've got section here, section there. Maybe we put the arm another section. So you kind of want to have it in sections so that when you later come to add the watercolors, you can add lots of different colors. Now you need to use the black glue. Now I've got a video up here how to make your own black glue, but to be honest, in essence, it's easy. You need glue and black paint. And then all you need to do next is follow all your outlines with your black glue. So I'm gonna do that on speed as usual. And you guys can just watch. And then once it's all dry, we'll come back and we'll paint. Dry, you can take an eraser and gently rub out any pencil marks that are left. But to be honest, I don't mind them so much. I'm going to leave them. I'm just going to rub out some of the really big obvious ones, but not the ones that go too close to my glue, because I don't want to smudge the glue by accident. And to be honest, having a few lines here and there is not a problem. Here we go. Maybe a few here. Just got the worst ones off, right? I have smudged the glue before, so it's best to stay careful. Then you get some watercolors like these. I don't know if you can see them very well. Any watercolors will do, to be honest, any paints will do. And then you just have fun and do a bit of painting. So I'm gonna kind of use the lighter watercolors up here, make it really watery, because I want it to really kind of have that under the sea effect. And also it means you can use the same color next to each other and it'll be darker in one and lighter in the other. And we'll just basically cover the whole sheet. It'll take a little while, but it's really lovely to do. So you can just watch whilst I get on with it. Piece of art finished. Take another closer look. Doesn't it look fabulous? I do think it looks like stained glass on paper. Now remember, you can do your own drawing or you can use a template down below, but whatever you do, just enjoy, have explore, experiment, and just get arty. Anyway, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and we'd love to see you again soon. Take care, bye.